Once upon a night, there was a cat, which in itself isn't unusual. What is unusual is that this particular cat had cold feet. But being smarter than the ordinary cat, he had a plan to remedy that situation. He climbed to a fence by one of the small houses of the kingdom and began to yowl at the moon for all he was worth. Inside of the small house, a young man who worked very long and hard in the okra fields for his bread and beans was sleeping. Or that is, he was trying to sleep.
I reason that he will soon grab the first thing that's handy, which will be his boots, and throw them at me and shut me up and... here they are now.
The cat then slipped on the boots and his feet were nice and warm. Meanwhile, the young man suddenly realized that he had thrown away the only pair of boots he had in the world and quickly dashed out to get them back. He saw the cat wearing his boots and grabbed the rascal by the neck.
Something's the matter with my throat. I can't talk.
Trying to steal my boots, huh? Just for that, I'm going to doom you.
Now, if there is anything that Pussycat didn't want, it was to be doomed, and he did some mighty fast talking.
Please, man, don't doom me.
Why not?
I'm a magic cat.
You're crazy.
No, really, I could talk, can I? Hey, you know very well ordinary cats can't talk.
Not even in cartoons?
I'll prove it to you. I hereby give you 3 wishes.
Oh, boy. All right, magic cat. For my first wish, I want you should make me rich.
Easy, man. I'll get to work on it first thing in the morning.
Early the next day, the cat set about the task of making the young man's first wish come true, but not exactly in the way that the young man had imagined.
Are you staying there? You want to be rich, don't you?
Yeah, but...
Relax, then. All you have to do is stay 150 rounds with that monster, and you'll win 1,000,000 pazoozas.
Yeah, but...
1,000,000 pazoozas is a lot of pazoozas, and... Good grief, here it comes.
Berserk was more berserk than he'd ever been before. He fought like a madman, and the poor young man took an awful beating.
Oh, I bet that smarts. Oh, that's gonna be blue tomorrow.
But somehow, the young man held together for the required 150 rounds and won the money.
Well, I did it, man. Yesterday you were nothing. Now look at you.
Let me ask you, am I still alive?
I don't know. What's your next wish?
No, you don't. I couldn't stand another wish. Go away.
Now, nonsense. You still have 2 wishes coming. You're not going to waste them.
Well, I...
Now that you're a man of means, how about wishing for a big house to live in? Come on. We'll get to work on it right now.
Now, it so happened that the only house for rent in the kingdom was one inhabited by a huge ogre. But the rent was a little more than they could afford for...
2,000,000 pazoozas?
But the clever cat had a scheme. He took out a small jar of termites and set them loose in the house.
Hey, Ogre, come here. You missed the chance of a lifetime.
I am?
Why, sure, you got a pigeon here. You should sell the jar. The place is loaded with termites. Take a look.
Termites? Good heavens. I had no idea.
Well, Ogre, sell them to you.
The ogre quickly sold the house for 1 pazooza and 38 cents, which is a good price even for a termite-infested house, and dashed away, happy as a troll.
What kind of a magic cat are you? You let me buy a house that's falling apart. Get out of my sight. Go away.
Not so fast. You still got 1 more wish coming in.
I don't want it.
With it, I will get you a bride so you can live happily ever after.
No, I don't want it. A bride?
Bride. Now you wait here.
The cat dashed off and in no time at all selected a bride and the young man was married. But he didn't exactly live happily ever after for...
You're just a lazy loafer, that's what you are. Scrub the floors, wash the windows, pay the kids, help you out with them.
Sheesh. What did you do? Pick her out of a bunch of good ones?
You pay attention to me while I'm yelling at you.
Yes, my love.
Now what about my fur coat?
Yeah, what about that?
I don't have one, that's what's about it. Everybody in the kingdom has a fur coat but me. You go into town this very minute and get me one.
But you spent all my pazoozas, my love. I can't get
it. No excuses. You get me a fur coat or else.
So, once again, the young man turned to the cat and asked,
please, magic cat, grant me 1 more wish to help me get a fur coat.
Sorry, man, but I'm not retired. Besides, us magic cats never grant more than 3 wishes to a customer.
But I gotta have a fur coat.
Don't come to me with your problems. You got yourself into this mess, get yourself out.
All righty, I will.
Hey, what do you think you're gonna do? Don't look at me like that. Stop!
So, once upon a night, there was a cat with cold feet, cold knees, cold chest, cold neck,